Hall of Famer Steve Farhood.
So, Jose Roman, you're fighting a top prospect in Barrios. Tell us what your approach will be. Why would you pull off the upset?
You know, they gave me a 3-week notice, you know, and we trained really hard for this, really, really smart. And, you know, I feel like I'm ready, you know, to win this fight.
You have special motivation. Tell us about that.
Yeah, my cousin, his son is battling leukemia. So, you know, I dedicated this fight for him. You know, he's only 3 years old, and battling leukemia is kind of hard, you know, because I'm a father, you know, and just imagining that breaks my heart.
Well, good luck to you, and best of luck to your cousin's son as well.
Thank you.
Mario Barrios, you told us you're excited to be fighting officially on Showtime for the first time. Why? What makes you excited?
Everything about it. I mean, like I said, this is something I've been working for, you know, my whole life. This is something I've been dreaming of since I was a kid, fighting on Showtime. And I mean, the opportunity is here, and I mean, I'm going to take it, you know, I'm going to take full advantage of it.
You want to make this a coming out party, obviously, for yourself. So what will boxing fans who see you for the first time tomorrow night, what will they be saying on Sunday morning?
They're gonna be saying a lot. I mean, I'm gonna go out there, showcase my talents. I mean, I love coming out here fighting in LA. I mean, I always get a lot of love. And I mean, they could definitely expect some fireworks come tomorrow night.
Wish you luck, Mario.
Thank you.
Yeah, baby.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we move along to our next fight. A 10-round heavyweight special attraction. We invite our fighters to the stage at this time. First, ladies and gentlemen, with a record of 16 wins, 3 losses, he has 9 wins coming by way of knockout. He's the former heavyweight world title challenger from Romania. Please welcome Razvan Canjou. And now, ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, 24 knockouts in his 28 victories as a pro. Here is the hard-hitting former heavyweight world title challenger fighting out of Miami by way of Cuba. Please welcome Luis King Kong Ortiz. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring our fighters to the scale. First, making his Showtime debut, here is the former world title challenger from Romania, Razvan Canjou. 269 pounds, 269 for Razvan Canjou. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is his opponent, currently ranked the WBC number 4 heavyweight contender in the world. Here he is, the hard-hitting Luis King Kong Ortiz. £241 for Luis King Kong Ortiz. Once again, we'll go with the same routine. We'll let our fighters get dressed. We'll bring them together for a photo opportunity. Then we'll have a short and brief Q&A. Gentlemen, 10 rounds of boxing heavyweight special attraction. Both of these fighters have fought for the world title. They'll meet in the center of the ring tomorrow night at Staples Center. 10 rounds of boxing heavyweight special attraction. Luis King Kong Ortiz, Razvan Canjou. Once again, here's Hall of Famer Steve Farhood.
Take your time. So Razvan, you had limited notice for this fight, only about 2.5 weeks, yet you came in lighter than you did when you fought Joseph Parker for one of the titles, so you must feel you're in great shape.
I'm in very good shape, and tomorrow night it's showtime. Tomorrow night we're gonna bring the pain.
Let me see, I didn't see that. Okay.
I tell you to let me to put the shirt. You're gonna like it.
That's good, you're selling yourself, I like it. What is the secret to beating, look at our cameras over here, what is the secret to beating King Kong?
It's no secret. The secret is two things. One, I cannot say because I'm in the front of the TV, but the other one is the heart.
We wish you luck. I can't reach that much. I can't. My arm is tired. Herman Caicedo, the trainer of Luis Ortiz, will translate for us. Can you ask Luis? His last fight, obviously, was Wilder. A disappointment when you fight for the heavyweight title and you come this close to winning it. How does he handle that psychologically, this, and not have a letdown?
Llegar tan cerca a ganar el título del mundo contra Wilder, psicológicamente, ¿cómo, sabes, cómo recuperas eso?
Salir a hacer mi trabajo, lo mejor que debes hacer es tirar al piñazo. Mañana vamos a hacer lo que hacemos.
He's going to do what he's always done in his entire career, even as an amateur, and that's just fight, you know, and tomorrow night it's going to be no different. He's going to come out, he's going to, you know, throw punches and definitely go for the, you know, the win and the KO.
Does he feel he's one win away from getting another shot at a heavyweight title?
Te sientes como si eres tan cerca como decir una pelea más para volver a pelear por un título.
Todas las peleas para mí son importantes y yo lo que quiero es volver a que Dios me vuelva a dar la oportunidad de pelear por el título. Y sí, todas son oportunidades y pienso que sí, que mañana lo voy a lograr.
Yeah, 100%. He feels that every fight is an important fight. Tomorrow he's going to show, you know, what he can do and what he's going to do. And, you know, being as avoided as he is, even more so, you know, one loss can be the end of it. So definitely one more win is even closer. So they're all important, yeah.
Good luck. Thank you, Herman.
Thank